in that culture of my friends, it was certainly seen as, don't vaccinate your kids, it's dangerous to do so.
Wow.
I know, right?
Yeah. I'm Mary Christa Smith, and I'm a lifelong Utahn and a mom of two wonderful people, Marley, who's here with me today, and Griffin, Marley's younger brother.
I'm 19 years old and currently attending the University of Utah, double majoring in psychology and gender studies. So I guess we're here to talk about misinformation and its real-world consequences. Mom, I know that you read some stuff about vaccines that turned out not to be true, and that led you to like vaccinate me later than was expected. So I'm just wondering like what went into that.
I was so excited to be pregnant with you and nervous and wanted to do the right thing and was really committed and dedicated to trying to do the right thing and the best thing for you. I also was surrounded by other moms who were very convinced that vaccines were dangerous. There had been an article that came out in the Lancet. It was an article by, I think his name is Andrew Wakefield, about the potential that the MMR vaccine could cause autism in babies.
So in the 1990s, Andrew Wakefield was a physician who enrolled about 12 children into a study where he made a link between the MMR vaccine and childhood autism. Since then, that study has been debunked by numerous sources, and the article itself was retracted, and Wakefield himself has faced censure as a physician, both in the United Kingdom and in the United States.
What necessarily helped you like come to terms with getting me vaccinated? Because I know I'm vaccinated now, but yes. What necessarily helped that process?
Your grandparents were really concerned about the fact that you weren't vaccinated. They grew up in a time where their friends had polio, and the miraculous, you know, polio vaccine really changed everything for my parents' generation. So your grandparents were highly, highly concerned that I was not vaccinating you. Both arguments seemed fear-based. To vaccinate you out of fear that you would get measles felt fear-based, and to not vaccinate you out of fear that there was something wrong with the vaccine.
Fear of what exactly?
Fear that you might get sick, that you might get autism. I was afraid that if I gave you the vaccine, fear of, you know, at the root of it, being a good mom, and fear of not being a good mom, or making the wrong choice, or doing something that out of ignorance or lack of experience was going to end up being harmful to you.
What do you think makes people more susceptible to this kind of misinformation?
I would say that my desire to want to do the right thing and to be a really good mom to you and to make sure that you were healthy certainly was driving a lot of my questioning and concern and a certain amount of cynicism. I think that, you know, there's mistrust that breeds people's susceptibility. And I would also say within the culture of my friend group, to bring up a contrary opinion was, you know, this was my support system. These were the moms who were my friends. It felt like you could be cast out of the group. It felt like you could lose support of your friends.
It really helps as a provider to ask the parents, you know, what are you worried about today? How can I help you understand this process? Or how can we connect a little bit more deeply on this rather than me just bombarding you with scientific information? And what it boils down to sometimes is just saying, hey, I'm a parent just like you're a parent. We both have the same objective here, which is to protect our children and guarantee they've got a great future in front of them. I vaccinate my children, and I would never advise you to do something that I don't do for my own children.
I mean, if you could go back and like talk to younger you when I was a baby, would you have any specific advice for her, or just what would you say?
I'm proud of the way I worked through it, honestly. I'm actually really proud of myself and grateful that I listened to my intuition and that I made those decisions based on facts and made those decisions based on science, but also on what I could live with as a mom personally.
I mean, that being said, I do have to ask, how do you feel with like the current pandemic?
Personally, as soon as I could get my COVID vaccine, I got signed up. And when I went and got it, I was surprised at the emotions that I felt when I got my first vaccine. I cried. I was just like the relief I felt. And the relief I felt when you and your brother and your grandparents in particular got the vaccine.
It's just really crazy to think just the amount of effort that you had to go through, the amount of thought that you put into vaccinating me. And I do want to say that I am just so grateful that you did. You know, I'm safe, I'm healthy, I haven't had the chicken pox. That's awesome. And it just, looking back, I understand that it was probably extremely hard to go against your friends and against, like, you know, your other feelings about it. But I just want to say thank you, and I'm very happy that you did.
Thanks for saying that, Mar. I'm glad you feel that way. I'm glad you're not like, how dare you vaccinate me?